बच्चों, हाय माय स्टूडेंट्स, माय लिसनर्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल प्रोफेसर सौरभ कौर। अगेन आई एम बैक विथ माय न्यू लेक्चर इन प्रीस्ट्रेस कंक्रीट स्ट्रक्चर्स। आज हम सीखेंगे अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक दैट इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू एनालिसिस एंड स्ट्रेसेस, एनालिसिस एंड स्ट्रेस डिजाइन। Today, we will learn a topic which is practically based, like design of some pre-stressed concrete structures. We will practically learn some design in pre-stressed concrete structures. So, chalo bachcho, aaj thoda design seekhte hain, okay? So, today's topic is design of pre-stressed concrete structures. I hope you have seen all my previous videos on shear, on development of anchorages, on basic analysis of pre-stressed concrete in flexure and other videos. So by and by, if you just see all or view all my videos from one by one, I am sure you will able to grasp all the core knowledge in pre-stressed concrete structures and the questions which comes in all the universities all over India. Today we will learn design of pre-stressed concrete poles. बहुत कॉमन टॉपिक है और बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक है, वेरी प्रैक्टिकली बेस्ड टॉपिक, डिजाइन ऑफ प्रीस्ट्रेस्ड कंक्रीट पोल्स। ओके, सो बिफोर कमिंग टू the design of pre-stressed concrete pole, I should say that there are many structures which we can design using the basic concepts of pre-stressed concrete and analysis. So first study that. As far as the design of pre-stressed concrete structures, we can learn, or the design we can learn, that is pre-stressed beams. We have normal pre-stressed beams, that is the basic topic, the basic or the preliminary design in pre-stressed concrete structures. Next, we can learn, the beams may be I section, the beams can be T section, and obviously the rectangular section. Next, we can learn design of pre-stressed slippers is another a very big application of pre-stressed concrete structures and design. Another, we can learn pre-stressed poles. Poles meaning we have transmission towers and poles. Also we can learn and apply design of pre-stressed chimney, design of pre-stressed concrete chimneys. This is also a very big avenue. So these four are the biggest area. Where we can learn design and practically implement in our practical construction site. It may be in metros, it may be for bridge construction, it may be for underground metro tunnel or other subground or underground structures, right? So today we will start with the pre-stressed concrete poles. Pre-stressed concrete poles. Now, first I will start with the basic applications of pre-stressed concrete poles and their advantages in what is the advantage of constructing pre-stressed poles compared to normal concrete poles and RCC poles. Now, first, design for pre-stressed concrete poles. We will starting first will be first is okay. Now, pre-stressed concrete design of pre-stressed concrete poles is used in power signal transmission poles, power signal transmission poles and masts. Masts, M-A-S-T-S. Masts are another type of poles, that is the pre-stressed concrete poles, which we call with a different name, that is called masts. Okay. Now, what are its higher advantages? What are the higher advantages of pre-stressed concrete poles? First, we will learn this thing. Advantages. Okay. Now, there are numerical advantages. There are numerous advantages to learn the design of pre-stressed concrete pole and obviously to implement in practical construction site. The first advantage is that it is resistant to cold weather conditions, humid climate. And temperature, right? Also erosion resistant in hot dry areas. Okay, so that means as far as the climatic condition is concerned, pre-stressed concrete poles are excel in that field. Second point is that it is comparatively lightweight and can be handled easily. Okay, second. Third point, it is freeze-thaw resistant. It is freeze-thaw. Freeze-thaw resistance meaning defrosting. It has the practical or it can defrost itself. Wherever there is high snowfall, high freezing temperature reaches quickly, in those areas we can have the application of pre-stressed concrete poles. So, freeze-thaw concrete. Next, we have fire-resistant. It is fire resistant, lightweight concrete, freeze-thaw concrete, then lightweight, it can be installed easily. It can be installed easily. Another very big application of prestressed concrete poles, then we have durable. It is durable, crack resistant. So there are number of applications or number of advantages of prestressed concrete poles. These are the main advantages that we all know about. So after this, I will begin with the basic analysis of prestressed concrete poles. So please take these down notes first. Written? If you have not written, please pause the video and take down the notes. Now, I will start with the analysis part. My students, it is a very, very important topic as far as prestressed concrete is concerned. बच्चो यहाँ से बहुत एक तो 12 या 15 मार्क्स का क्वेश्चन आ ही जाता है इसमें. Guaranteed question will come from this, say, any college, any institute. It may be IITs, it may be NITs, wherever institute you are studying. This question of design of prestressed poles or design of sleepers will surely come. So let's see, today we will learn the details of design. The design analysis of poles. Okay. Now, first of all, let us consider a pole, a prestressed PC. I am for writing in short, okay? The PC stands for prestressed concrete. So, consider prestressed concrete pole subjected to vertical load, W. First you write down, then I will explain each and everything. बच्चों सारे चीज I will explain you. कोई भी ऐसा टॉपिक नहीं रहेगा इसमें जो मैं अच्छे से डिस्कस नहीं करूंगा. आपको पता है प्रोफेसर सौरभ कौर हर दम आप लोग के लिए तैयार है टू शेयर वीडियोज, टू अपलोड एनी वीडियोज यू हैव एनी डाउट्स. एंड प्लीज 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 मेरे बच्चों, माय लिसनर्स, माय हार्ट वार्मिंग लिसनर्स, जो भी सुन रहे हो, माय सीनियर्स, my juniors, my professors, please everyone, it's a request, please subscribe, at least 1 million subscribes to hona chahiye. Okay, thank you. So vertical load and horizontal load. Q. Okay. Now first I will draw a pole. Okay. Now also coming to this point, we see that बहुत सारा बच्चों का ये doubt होता है कि sir poles, what is the difference between poles and chimneys? Poles and chimneys का difference क्या है? Poles and chimneys, right? First of all, pole का जो dimension होता है, it is completely uniform. The width for any pole is long standing and the width is uniform. वाइल चिमनीज के लिए क्या होता है, एट टॉप यू हैव वन टाइप ऑफ यू हैव वन टाइप ऑफ विथ एंड एट द बॉटम यू हैव अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ विथ. सो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द पोल्स एंड चिमनी इज दैट द पोल्स हैव द यूनिफॉर्म क्रॉस सेक्शन एंड द डेप्थ एंड इन चिमनीज द विथ्स आर चेंजिंग. दिस इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन पोल्स एंड चिमनीज. ओके, डू नॉट कंफ्यूज माई स्टूडेंट्स से सर चिमनीज का तो ऐसे होता है पोल्स का क्यों नहीं. दिस इज द ट्रेडिशन. ओके, एंड ऑब्वियसली द अदर डिफरेंसेस आर द एप्लीकेशन, द विंड लोड, द लोड कमिंग इफेक्ट, दोज आर डिफरेंट. ओके, लेट मी ड्रॉ. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम ड्रॉइंग अ पोल. लेट मी टेक अ पोल. ओके, लेट ए बी टिल बी इट इज द ग्राउंड लेवल. It is ground level. Till B, it is ground level. And so AB is the total. ABC is the total pole. AB is above the ground level, and BC portion is penetrated inside the ground level. Okay, BC is penetrated inside the ground level. Let me take the height of the pole BH, and below the ground level B small h. Okay, so first of all, if you write down, h is the height of the pole above ground level, and small h is the height of the pole penetrated below the ground. Penetrated below the ground. Okay, so like this. Okay, so I already told you. So here we will have a load W and a lateral load Q. Load W and lateral load Q. Now, how these loads are coming? First, we have to understand this. I am not going to detail analysis of the lateral load or the vertical load, but just I will tell you that how or why the load is coming on the pole. The first thing, the load consideration, the loadings on the pole. The loadings on the pole. The loadings on the pole. Okay. First is vertical load W. Vertical load W is the weight of the wires, because these poles will carry, right? These poles will carry wires. These poles will carry wires. I told you transmission towers, transmission poles, they carry transmission wires, high voltage wires. So vertical load is the weight of the wires. Weight of the wires, right? Second is the lateral or the horizontal load. The lateral or the horizontal load, that is Q. Q, it may change, because this Q, sometimes it is basically we are taking as the wind load. So sometimes the wind may be come from left to right. Sometimes the wind may be come from right to left. Like this, wind from left to right or from right to left, that is a lateral load. So this lateral load Q, it changes. It is acting at top A. And let me write it properly. Acting at top A, which changes its direction. Which changes the direction along horizontal plane. Along horizontal plane, which may vary. Right? So what is it? It changes its direction along the horizontal plane, which may vary. That means maybe left to right or from right to left. Okay, so this is the thing. Now, so this vertical load, so what? So we have two main type of load, vertical load and the lateral load. Now let us, if you take the vertical load is very small and can be neglected. Now you can say, sir, ये vertical load जो आ रहा है W, that is the weight of the wire, sir. और इसका self weight कहाँ गया? Where is the self weight of the poles? So that means the W also carries self weight of the pole. Self weight of the poles. Obviously, you can carry the determine the self weight of the poles if you know the cross section, breadth and depth, and the height of the pole multiplied with the unit weight of concrete, right? V into unit weight of concrete, volume into unit weight of concrete, right? Sorry, but rho gamma, right? Like this. So it is small and can be naked. But due to lateral loading, due to this lateral horizontal loading, the bending moments are very high. The bending moments, first of all, we have to know that the bending moments will be very high. So, maximum bending moment are very large. Maximum bending moment are very large. Okay? And is subjected in both direction. And subjected to both sides. Both direction meaning both sides. Right? Subject to both sides. And that is why it is pretension. It is pretension. The beam is pretension. Because the tensile stresses will be developed. Tensile stresses will develop. So what is happening? Depending on the value of Q, this lateral load Q, we have the maximum bending moment which is subjected to the both sides of the pole, and it is pretension. It is pretension. Tensile stresses will be developed. Right? Tensile stresses will be developed. So first write it down. Okay, so you have written down this one. Now, after this, another there are considerations. It will be a long lecture, my students. So, hold your breath, be concentrated and listen to my video, okay? Now, the thing is that, okay, now loadings, another point comes, that is to avoid large sections, pre-stressing is done. To avoid large section, pre-stressing is done. Okay? So, this is the thing. To avoid large section, pre-stressing is done. Now, coming to this diagram of pole, as I told you, this region, my students, is under the soil. So, this will be so under soil. Since it is under soil, we will have a soil pressure. We will have a soil pressure here. right? Gamma, gamma soil pressure, right? Okay. So now soil pressure, and obviously this will be h by 3. We have the soil pressure acting on this pole, and the centroid of the soil pressure will be acting at h by 3 because it is a triangular section. If you have known the centroids, the concepts of centroids and CG taught in the first year mechanics or in strength of materials, you know this thing, okay? Another diagram which we will do, that is the bending moment diagram, BMD. Okay. I told you that the maximum BMD occurs. Now see where the maximum bending occurs. This is also a big thing. The maximum bending moment occurs. This is the BMD diagram. BMD pattern. Okay. The BMD pattern will be like this. The BMD pattern will be something like this. Not at B. This is A. This is B. Something at this position. Let this position be Y. So this is basically A max. This is basically A max. Okay. So at this zone, at a section Y below the ground level B, we will have the maximum bending moment. Obviously, you will ask me, sir, kaise ho raha hai? How it is occurring? No problem. By solving problems, by solving numericals, we will see that the maximum bending moment usually comes just slightly below the ground level. Slightly below the ground level. Now come to our analysis. So this is the BMD pattern. BMD pattern continuously go on increasing. Okay. And we will have the maximum bending moment at some section, which is the distance Y. Which is Y distance below the point B. So we will find out, we will calculate the distance of the section. Right. Now, so this is first, you pause the figure, you pause the video and take down the diagram. Okay? Now see. So, analysis of maximum bending moment. Analyzing bending moments. Analyzing bending moments. Okay. If you see this diagram Q, now I told you that this Q is a lateral force. This lateral force is resisted by the soil pressure. This lateral force is resisted by the soil pressure, right? So the lateral force Q is resisted by this force coming due to soil pressure. Resisted by the force developed due to soil pressure, right? Now coming to the concept of soil pressure, come back to the concept of active and passive soil pressure, active and passive coefficient. If you remember, first of all, let me take B is the width of the pole. Let us take B is the width of the pole. Okay. B is the width of the pole. Right. So if we take Cp is the passive coefficient of passive soil pressure, earth pressure, soil means earth pressure actually. Coefficient of passive earth pressure, right? Coefficient Cp is coefficient of passive earth pressure, where Cp is 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. Okay, and you know the what is the angle phi? You know what is the angle phi? The angle phi is nothing but the cohesion. Cohesion angle. Okay. Those who have learned soil mechanics, you know better than me. Okay, fine. So if we know the Cp, the coefficient of active earth pressure, then what we will do? Passive earth pressure on BC will be nothing but Cp W A square by 2 into B. What will be factor? Cp is a factor, area of the triangle half into breadth into height, right? And this is the thing acting on the B. The Cp W A square by 2 into multiplied with B. This is the passive earth pressure. Okay. Now, so we know this thing. So this passive earth pressure is registered by Q. This passive earth pressure on the pole which is beneath the soil, acting beneath the soil. So therefore the horizontal force, lateral force Q is resisted by passive earth pressure. Okay, my students, at each and every line, at each and every statement, there are concepts involved. So my students, please slowly and slowly grasp the concepts and install in your mind, because it's very important. Okay, and if you once know the basic concepts of how to design this passive design of pre-stressed concrete poles, then it will be very easy to solve any type of questions whatever you get in an examination. So Q is registered by active pressure. Now we will take moment about this point. We will take moment about point C. Therefore, considering hinge action at C, what we will take? We will take bending moments. We will take moments about C. Take moments about C. Okay. So therefore, what will be the moments? If you take this Q, so that means what? Force into distance at this point, the Q into this distance, that will be equals to this. So we have one moment according to this direction, right side, left to right, and one moment from right to left acting at h by 3 distance from ground level, right? Like this. So simultaneously moments will be acting like this. If you follow my pen, everyone, if you follow my axis of pen, so the moments will be acting like this, correct? So therefore, Q capital H plus small h will be equated with Cp. First of all, let us take the first formula. Cp W A square by 2 into B. That will be multiplied by H by HP. Simple. Q into H plus Q into H plus capital H plus small h equals to Cp, the initial earth pressure, the total earth pressure multiplied with the lever arm H by 3, because it is triangular section. You know the concept we use also in hydrostatic pressure, in water pressure. So from this, if you equate this, you will get the equation Cp W H square H cube, sorry, Cp W H cube by 6 multiplied with B is equals to Q into H plus H. This is first equation. This is the first equation, okay? This is the first equation. So this is the first equation, right? The first basic principle equation to analyze. The first basic equation to analyze. I don't have. Okay. So this is the first basic equation. Now, so we have got, this is the basic equation. Everyone, please listen to this lecture. This is the basic first equation. So if we know, now this is the basic equation. Now if we know, for example, please my students listen. If we know capital H will be given, Q will be given, B we will assume, W will be given, Cp will be given. So we can find out H, this small h, right? If we know the capital H, if we know the height of the pole, if we know the Q, if we know the Cp, all the parameters except small h, it means this height. First of all, we have to find out this height, that is the height of penetration of the pole inside the soil. Okay, so based on this equation, now we will calculate this, the section. Based on this basic equation, we will calculate the section Y. I showed you in the previous figure, the bending moment diagram, BMD like curve, the Y section we have to calculate, right? So chalte hai, abhi we will calculate Y. Okay, so now to calculate maximum bending moment, to calculate the maximum bending moment at section y from b, okay? So we are taking section Y at B, because I told you the maximum bending moment occurs at the section below the ground level, okay? So we will replace H with Y. We replace H with Y, and the shear force will be zero. We all civil engineers know the basic concept of structure analysis. For any beam, any structure that may be curved, cleat, that may be a cylinder, the section where shear force is zero, bending moment is maximum. So we take the Cp. So the equation will be Cp Wy square by 2 into B, that is equals to nothing but Q. Where is the shear force? It is the equation for shear force. Okay. So from here, we will calculate y 2q by CPB, 2q by CPB into w root over. Okay. This is the equation to calculate the section of the section at which we will get the maximum bending moment. Maximum bending moment. Okay. So this is what is the whatever this is everything what I discussed regarding the structural analysis, that is a bending moment calculation in the poles. So my students, in the problems of design of poles, first thing is we have to assume the depth. Assume any depth of the pole cross section. My student bachcho, the answer dekho, if you take a rectangular section, then it will be B, it will be D, right? Depth of the pole section. First we will assume. Second is that we will calculate y. We will calculate maximum bending moment. We will calculate h also. I told you, we will calculate h, and then we will calculate the last thing, that will be b. Okay, so these are the steps. This is the chronology of how we will solve the analysis problem. Now the second phase is analysis of pre-stressing force or effect of pre-stress. Now, the second phase, phase 2, analysis of pre-stress or effect of pre-stress. Okay, analysis of pre-stress or effect of pre-stress. Analysis of pre-stress and effect of pre-stress, right? Analysis of pre-stress, we will take, let P is the initial pre-stress, P0. P0 is the initial pre-stress. Then you may also take PI, whatever you imagine. PI or P0 is initial pre-stress. Then alpha P0, let us take alpha P0 is the final pre-stress. Final pre-stressing force. Okay. P0 is the initial pre-stress. Alpha P0 is the final pre-stress. Okay. Now, similarly, if we take C as the initial pre-stress in concrete, C is the initial pre-stress in concrete. Initial pre-stress in concrete, then alpha C will be nothing but C dash is a final pre-stress in concrete. Alpha is nothing but the loss ratio. We know everyone. The loss factor. Obviously, these are after losses. After losses. So, these are the after losses condition. Okay. Now, to reduce, to have, okay, so C and alpha C. Now, to avoid tensile stresses, what to do? To avoid tensile stresses, what we are doing? We are doing pre-stressing. The bending stress should be limited to less than equals to alpha C. The bending stress should be limited to less than alpha C. Now the bending stress before losses, if we consider bending stresses before losses. So that will be C. So that will be nothing but C plus alpha C. That is C 1 plus alpha. That should be less than equals to FC. Where is C is the, we have learned while learning the elastic shortening of concrete, elastic shortening of pre-stress concrete, FC was taken as the permissible stress in concrete. FC is the permissible stress in concrete, right? So C multiplied with 1 plus alpha should be less than equals to or should be within the permissible concrete, right? Permissible stress. So therefore we usually take this equation C 1 plus alpha, we equate that, should be equals to FC, right? C 1 plus alpha, this where FC will be given. C 1 plus alpha should be equals to FC, right? Now, coming to another point, that is, if we take the elastic shortening, now loss in stress in concrete one thing, my students, everyone please listen. Whenever we have to design, practically we have to design pre-stressed concrete structures, whether it may be poles or whether it may be sleepers, we have to take the initial pre-stress and also we have to take the effect of final pre-stress, that is the taking the loss effect. Now, loss in stress in concrete due to elastic shortening, we all know delta FP, that is nothing but M into C, right? M into C, where M is the modular ratio. Everyone also we know that ES by EC, right? Modular ratio. Okay. So this is the stresses concept in concrete. Now we will take into consideration the stresses affecting steel. Next. Residual, if we take the residual stress in steel, that is nothing but relaxation. Okay, that is not reservation. That is, if we take as T dashed, okay. Then initial stress in steel, initial stress in steel will be equals to MC. The initial stress in steel will be equals to MC because we take the assumption, this not an assumption, the basic principle of pre-stressed concrete, that the stress in steel will be somewhat equals to the stress in concrete. The stress in steel will be somewhat equals to the stress in concrete. Write this. So that is why we are taking the initial stress in steel also as MC. M is the modular ratio. C here is small actually. Okay. And C is the bending stresses. Right. If we know this concept, then we have to equate the compression and tension. So therefore, equating tension and steel tendons, tension in steel tendons equals to compression in concrete. We will have like this equation. What is the stress relation? T dash multiplied with AT, that is the area of steel, is nothing but equals to, we have C multiplied with AC. It's T multiplied with AC, where AT is the area of steel in tendon. And AC is area of concrete. Okay. AC is the area of concrete. So, bachcho, you have taken all these notes. I think you have paused the video and you have taken the notes. So tension. And compression C. So from here we can get AT by AC is nothing but C by T dash. Right? AT by AC is equal to C by T dash. AT by AC equals to C by T dash. Right? Now therefore, so this is one phase. This is one phase. Now again, actually students, if you feel bored, please concentrate, because at this stage we will actually calculate the width of the pole. We will actually calculate the, not the width, the depth of the pole. Sorry, the depth of the pole. To find out the depth of the pole D, we have to do these things. Okay. Again, the bending stress is nothing but, we know that alpha into C, right? After losses, bending stress after losses is nothing but alpha into C, right? Now, and we assume the pole section is nothing but B into D, right? Assume the pole section, that is B into D. Very nice. So our ultimate moment of resistance will be nothing but the maximum bending moment, M max. The ultimate moment of resistance, that is for any section, the ultimate moment of resistance will be equal to M max. This is how we find out the depth. So now, the ultimate moment of resistance, 1 by 6 alpha C BD square, 1 by 6 alpha C BD square will be equals to m max. So from there we will get the d. D is equals to root over of 6m max, the maximum bending moment divided by alpha c into b. So the depth, from here we will get the depth of the pole. My students, I just made a mistake by stating that we will assume the width of the pole. We will assume the width of the pole. Okay, first, instead of the depth, as I told you, we will first calculate the width of the pole, and similarly, based on this, we will calculate the depth of the pole. Okay, so bachcho, this is the thing which we will, this will end our question. So please check this down properly.